goes high, he fakes high. That's where Logano goes. He loses control of his car.
Yeah, you cannot blame that on Elliott Sadler. No doubt. He went to go high the 22 blocks, so he changed it. And he says, all right, I'm going to go low. And it just pulled the air off the 22 right there. The 22 wrecked.
Third first-time winner we've had in the history of Talladega Super Speedway in the NASCAR Xfinity Series.
What a great job by Elliott Sadler. Crashed on the back straightaway, but yet vying for the win on the front. Just gets pushed low and can't keep his momentum up to win the race.
How about Jeremy Clements for the third-place finish? Great run for that team.
And Justin Allgaier, so close to victory last week at Richmond, and then again this Saturday afternoon in Alabama. Such a shame for Blake Koch. He just was in a position there was nowhere for him to go.
See, Allgaier, it looked like he was just dirt tracking it, sliding up the racetrack in the pool.
Drafting going on. When you were up front, you were so vulnerable to being pushed around by the person behind you, and that's exactly what happened.
Watch Elliott. If Ray moves the outside, we're going to pop you there. Got to go low. Elliott Sadler did everything he had to do to win this race. Joey Logano. He was trying to win that race. Both those guys were just racing.
NASCAR is still reviewing the finish, and they will have all of our angles at their disposal to confirm that it was the 48 at the start-finish line. Unofficially, we had the margin of victory at 26 one-thousandths of a second, so just over 2/100ths. And I think about Brendan Poole out of the Woodlands, Texas. Spent a lot of time on the short tracks out west.
Yeah.
Ran in ARCA, and when he didn't have a ride, was going to the track, working in the shop, doing anything he could do to stay around the sport. Got this opportunity last year. Brought over his sponsor, DC Solar. And it appears he's in victory lane for the first time in his career.
They won't give him the checkered flag, Adam. He's heading down at the start-finish line. Say, please, can I just have it? I know I won this race. Let's see what the video shows here.
What would you anticipate they're looking at? Because I never saw the caution lights come on. And the only thing I can think of is that NASCAR would have deemed the caution lights came on before they got to the start-finish line and Poole was not leading at the time.